July 17th, 1944, Ministry of War. Director General for Conscripts and NCOs. We are grieving over your sudden loss, and we send you our heartfelt condolences. The Lieutenant Colonel Rapporteur.
Interesting. Start again.
July 17th, 1944, Ministry of War. Director General for Conscripts and NCOs. We are grieving over your sudden loss, and we send you our heartfelt condolences. The Lieutenant Colonel Rapporteur. There's no reason to use the phone right now.
Oh shit, first person.
A telegraph box. I know how to use it. Daddy taught me.
I think I'm not wrong, which I could be. Oh no, yeah. This is what I'm supposed to do. Okay.
When you're done, can you come and get the flowers, please? Or send Martha if you like.
Never a moment's peace. Even at a time like this, she can't sit still for a second. Daddy's oboe. We were preparing a really nice duet together. On the rare occasions he's at home, that is.
Right. What do I do here?
Hell! The moment I thought I saw... No, no, that's not possible. It must be this whole situation making me see things that don't exist.
What?
Daddy's canes. They are so beautiful, but I can't say why, but they have always scared me. When Mummy asks for something, there's no escaping it.
Okay, I'll do it. Just calm down. Flooring, press print button. It's all one.
Books, books, and more books. In our villa, there must be 10 times more than even here. Daddy, Mummy, and my grandparents. It seems almost impossible that Father is a soldier. Mother would have been more suitable if she wasn't a woman. I can't turn it off. We have to listen to the radio all of the time. Any news and announcements can be vital. To go, or she'll end up getting seriously angry.
Yeah, fine, I guess we'll keep that. Man, I'm going. Hey.
Everything always has to be perfect with her.
Hello?
Parla Londra. Trasmettiamo alcuni messaggi speciali. Felice non è felice. È cessata la pioggia. La mia barba è bionda. Parla Londra. Abbiamo trasmesso alcuni messaggi speciali.
What? That was strange. Ask not for who the bell tolls.
What's happening? Who closed the door?
Erich! Erich, wake up! Do you think it's appropriate to sleep here? Of all places?
What? Yes. I must have fallen asleep.
What are they talking about?
You can't stay here forever. Why don't you go to bed?
No, no. I want to stay with my daughter.
Your daughter? Your daughter? You have another daughter, you know. The one who's still alive. Remember?
What are you talking about, Irena? Julia is dead. What kind of comment is that? How can you?
You should be thinking about Martha. Julia harmed Martha. You know that, right? And as if that were not enough, she has now also abandoned her.
It's the same old story. Everything is always Julia's fault, isn't it? Her fault for Martha being deaf and for you being infertile. Do you think it's the right time for this? Julia is dead, Irena. Dead. Someone killed her. Do you realize that?
Of course I realize. I get it. Do you think I'm stupid? No one understands it better than me. She always brought problems. Only problems. It would have been better if she hadn't been born at all. You're crazy.
I'm the crazy one? Me? They have done this to get at me, yes. Your death is all my fault. All I could ever do for you was hurt you, Julia. My poor, sweet, crazy girl. What will I do without you? What will life be like now? All the time I didn't spend with you. But now I'm home. We can go fishing together. We can take pictures of butterflies. No. We can't do anything together anymore, can we? Nothing. I miss you. Julia, I miss you.
While American bombings continue to devastate the peaceful towns within the Elsa Valley, we have heard some tragic news from the area of La Ramula. The young daughter of German Army General Erich K. was murdered near her home. What possible reason could there have been behind such a cowardly act? This is what the Carabinieri, who immediately intervened, hope to find out.
Mother didn't seem to suffer from the situation. All she cared about was that my death was so painful for Martha. But not having me around anymore must have been a great relief to her. At the end of the day, it was better for everyone that it was me who died. And it was better for me, too, that people thought that. But the guilt began to consume me. That's when I started having horrible nightmares.
Am I supposed to pick Martha? I'll keep this going for a little bit longer. Did I do a 180? No? Okay. Wait, what if I'm in the middle? Martha has found... I was wrong. Fine, Martha. Has lost Martha has lost her. Oh. Back at it again. I will give. Nope. I stole her identity. This video is getting demonetized. Oh yeah, some girl's pulling a Bubba. Texas Chainsaw Massacre style. Okay, this is a little disturbing. Oh my god.
It was just a dream. A horrible dream. That horrendous woman and the face of my sister. I wish all of this was a dream and my sister is just sleeping in her bed. Instead, her bed is empty and this is reality.